you will learn how to use the map module by doing vibration and fly rock prediction. Click on the map module and select the attenuation law that you saved previously. Then enter your location on Google Earth or enter the corresponding UTM zone. With this, you will be able to get a bird's eye view of your location. After this, move your blast to the desired location by right-clicking on the mouse and selecting Move Blast. You will notice that concentric circles will appear, indicating the different PPV, peak particle velocity, prediction values that will be associated with each circle according to the distance to your blast. You can also change the interval between circles. To check for structural damage, select Add Structure and insert all relevant information, and move the mouse over the structure to check the predicted value of PPV, as well as the intended limit value. You can also visualize charge limits and critical blast zones. Change values and corresponding colors by clicking on Edit Charge Limits. For the critical blast zone, check the critical blast zone box, and the black circumference will appear. For the safety calculations, you have the possibility to use one of two methods to calculate safety zones. Either enter the meters for each safety zone, personnel, and equipment, or insert an empirical constant value. For this last option, you can choose what rock breaking mechanism, face burst, cratering, or rifling, the software should consider for the calculations, both for the first row and for the remaining, as well as, if you wish, to use your crest as a limiter for the safety zones. Thank you. The software allows you to check for structural damage as well. Click on the Blast Results tab and then on Check Structures. A green message will appear on the bottom right corner in case there is no damage, or a red message will appear if otherwise. Finally, add, edit, or delete attenuation loss in the database if needed.